Unit 4 is design of power screw and fastener. The first question is, what is meant by power screw and what is the difference between simple screw and power screw? Here the power word is attached with the screw. That means these screws are used to transmit power. म्हणून त्याला आपण power screw असं म्हणतो. Here, what is the basic purpose of screw? The screw is going to transmit rotary motion into translatory motion. When the power is to be transmitted from rotary motion to some translatory motion, screw is used, and that type of screw is called as a power screw. There are variety of power screw available as per the application, as per the advantages, and as per the use. In front of you, there are four different kinds of power screw. The first one is having thread profile, which is called as a square thread profile. The square thread profile is having 90 degree including angle. A straight threads are there, but it has some disadvantages. That's why some inclined threads are also developed. So in the inclined thread, which includes angle of 29 or 30, which also called as a trapezoidal thread or ACME or ACME thread. In that also, the thread profiles are almost straight, but it has some including angle. In addition to that, there is one more common power screw, which is called as a buttress thread. The buttress thread is having somewhat different thread profile as compared to square thread or trapezoidal thread. Buttress thread is having thread profile, one edge is exactly vertical and another edge is having including angle of 45 degrees. So let us go further and learn how these different threads are useful to us. As far as square thread is concerned, these slides are very, very important as far as MCQs are concerned. In our MCQs, there may be chances that you must identify the profile which is given in the figure, simple question, or there may be chances that you may ask some advantages or disadvantages in the MCQs. So in front of you, there is a square thread. Square thread profile figure is given. As far as advantages concerned, the square thread will take total load on the flat surface. So almost whatever load is there, it will carry efficiently. So that's why it has a maximum efficiency. There is a maximum efficiency as well as the force is exactly on the thread on the flat surface because it is 90 degree. There is no any radial directional pressure on the nut. Radial pressure means the pressure or the force which are along the radius of the nut, which are exactly perpendicular to the load. So along the radius, there is no pressure. Why there is no or minimum pressure on the nut? Because the square thread are having very, very flat surface. And whatever load is there, the load is taken by that flat surface. So there is no any chance of radial bifurcation or split of that load. Again, manufacturing of this square thread, is again exactly at 90 degrees. So it requires some skill. That's why it comes under disadvantage. We need single point cutting tool on the lathe. So develop such type of square thread, because exact 90 degree is the need of the square thread. If you think about the strength wise, this thread is having uniform cross section from top to bottom. So the strength of bottom of this thread profile is not that much strong as compared to other. So strength of the square thread is comparatively less than the other. Next is, here when we think about the wear, what is meant by wear? Wear means if because of contact between screw and nut, there may be chances that some part of the material is get wear out. And if the part of material is get wear out, there is a gap. If there is a gap between that, then it creates some backlash. So nut and screw, if it has some gap between the threads, then there is no any compensatory or there is no compensation provided in the square thread. So that gap remains as it is. We cannot do for that gap because already the material is wear out. So wear compensation is not possible. After some days, after some period of service, there may be chances that the square type of threads are having some error. As far as applications are concerned, where these square threads are used, the square threads are used in screw jack, presses, pipe wise, clamping device, etc. But it has square thread, the square thread has limited application as far as strength is concerned. If the strength is more needed, we need to go for another type of thread profile. So the next thread profile, which is somewhat going to overcome the disadvantage of square thread, is ACME or trapezoidal thread. Definitely there will be question based on this, because in the ACME or ACME threads, the including angle is 29 degrees. Whereas if you just see the figure of trapezoidal thread, it has including angle of 30 degrees. Based on this including thread angle, you may have question, which thread power thread profile is having including angle of 30 degrees. So answer should be trapezoidal thread. So such type of question may be asked. There may be question like this. The figure is shown and you have to identify the thread profile. So such type of simple question is also may ask. As far as advantage and disadvantages are concerned, obviously whatever disadvantages are there for the square thread, these disadvantages are overcome by this trapezoidal or ACME threads. You can see that advantages in front of you, as it has some inclined thread profile, the wear compensation can be possible. It has a wider base as compared to square thread. So obviously stronger than the square thread because of the wider base. But as the inclination is provided to this thread profile, some part of the total load is again resolved into tangential direction and some part is on the radial direction. As there is a radial direction force, it directly goes towards the radius and it gives a radial pressure on the nut. So that are the disadvantages. So in the disadvantage, as compared to square thread, it has less efficiency. As far as radial pressure is concerned, radial pressure is there on the nut. Why there is a radial pressure? Because when the load is coming from the top on this thread, as there is a 29 and 30 inclination, it creates that load, it resolves the load into two direction. One is vertical and another is horizontal. Whatever horizontal component of that weight, it creates radial pressure or radial force. And that radial force is on the nut walls. So radial pressure is there on the wall of the nut. So that's why it has less efficiency and we have to overcome that radial pressure which is coming on the nut. Manufacturing is somewhat easier than our square thread. We can manufacture this trapezoidal thread by a very simple manufacturing process. You can cut a complete thread by using some dies and you can cut accordingly. So it has strong applications. It will take strong load. So applications are lead screw of the machine tools, bigger size screw jack, heavy duty screw jack are the applications of trapezoidal and ACME thread profile of the power screw. Now one more type of thread profile is there, so which is called as a buttress thread profile. This buttress thread profile is having one flat and another having some 45 degree incline face. The flat face is just like a face of square thread, whereas incline face is having some angle, 45 degree angle is provided. Why there is a need of such type of modification? So we can take advantages of maximum efficiency just like a square thread and we can manufacture it very easily. So that's why buttress threads are modified like this. So advantages of buttress thread is it can manufacture it easily. It has a higher efficiency as that of square thread. The wear compensation is also possible. It has a wider base, so strong in shear and other type of stresses. So it overcome some advantages, but it has very strong disadvantage. The buttress thread will take load in single direction. It cannot useful for the power transmission in both directions. Why? Because one side is having 45 including angle. So there is only one flat face. So on that flat face only we can give load. On 45 face, if you give load, then it creates very high radial pressure. And because of that radial pressure, it cannot take much more load very easily. It will create very huge wear and all the other problems. That's why That's why these buttress threads are useful where unit direction force is necessary. Where it is necessary? So we know that when we require single direction force to be applied, like press, in the press we need to apply the force in single direction, just like our pipe vise or clamping devices. Or you might have seen the fitter vise. The fitter vise is the best example that you might have not seen that because you didn't have any practical in fitting shop. Because of this COVID and all situation. But bench vise is the best example of this buttress thread where we need to have single direction force application. So this is all about the introduction of various kind of power screws. Now this is one example screw jack. In the screw jack, the vertical screw is used to lift the load. You might have seen this screw jack in your day-to-day life for the cars and for the trucks. We need this type of jack to lift the wheel if it has some puncture or other maintenance required. So this is one figure. Now we are going to design the screw jack in our next 2 to 3 lectures. So tomorrow we are going to see about design of this screw jack or power screw.